welcome to Poland again on this beautiful cold autumn day, to which I did not dress correctly because while we were working at home the temperature was really comfortable in our office. Today I would like to share with you things that I found weird, and when I say I find weird, I'm talking about my Portuguese background or South of Europe background when I moved to Poland. The first thing that I found weird for me, it's the following. Polish people by nature are a bit more colder than Portuguese, and they keep a huge distance between people. Like, you cannot go and have the same touchy connection, but when it comes to be on a line waiting for something to buy or to pay, it's like they are hugging each other and they don't give like a centimeter between themselves. And it's funny because it happens so often that I'm in a supermarket and as soon as the person in front of me moves, I already feel the car, the shopping cart behind me, pushing my butt. Or remember this time that a lady, we still didn't find, stop putting our shopping, and she was already putting on top of our shopping, and I put my hand and was like, I don't care, I block everything. So, coincidence, it's usually old people that make these kind of sneaky moves. But it happens a lot, like, Polish people love lines. Like,
okay, but the reason for the old people, you know, to be like that is that they had to fight for their place in the queue during communism. And it's actually funny because we even have this company that makes products connected with communist times in Poland, and they are called Pan tu nie stał, which means you didn't stand here.
Yeah.
Because that was like a popular line during that time.
There's actually this very popular board game. We have it and I love it actually. It's called Kolejka, which means queue. And you have to make lines. You have a shopping list and you have to make lines and stay there. And the first one to make the shopping list wins. And it's actually funny and portrays those times of communism in Poland. This next one is actually funny. If some of you have Polish friends, you will know about this. Is that one of the biggest sports in Poland is complaining, and you can never complain next to a Polish person, because even if you are saying just how you feel and you feel bad, then you'll start a competition and you don't want to do that. For example, I found out this very early that one day I woke up and I said, today I have headache, and immediately someone says, like, yeah, I also have headache, my back hurts and I have pain on my knees. And then, okay, of course I lost that competition, but it's something that it's very common on their culture, that they love to complain, and if you start to complaining, they can do it for hours and hours without stopping. Dun, 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 ta-da-da, ta-da, ta-da. Look at this in Poland. Is it a unicycle? It's a dinosaur? It's a man dressed as a mountain biker on a dinosaur unicycle? No one knows. Okay, so tell again.
You cannot have what you really want, but you can have what you want. It was delicious.
When I came to Poland, I thought that, man, Polish people really have problems with their stomachs, because you can find everywhere the stomatologia, which is another word that they have for dentists. What actually means stomatologia? Because you also have dentistka, dentist, you have this clinics.
Stomatologia, it's a medical general term.
Yeah, but
for
it's
this branch.
No, but usually it's dentists.
The people, yes, they're dentists.
Yeah.
But they are also stomatologists.
And I thought, like, man, these Polish people have, you know, because it's dentists most of these places, and like they really have problems with their stomachs here in Poland. I wonder if it's from their food or vodka. So this next one is funny, because this we never made this in Portugal, and it was funny that in the beginning, Maria, when we started dating, she was asking where my mom is going, just because my mom was walking on shoes at home. But in Poland, the shoes stay at the entrance of the house. So you don't walk with your dirty shoes inside of the house. And actually, this can be offensive. Like, it happened to me sometimes, I entered someone's house and I didn't take shoes, and I heard the sentence like, hey, I just cleaned the floor. So don't forget, if you are visiting Poland, this curiosity is actually something that you should pay attention to.
Curiosity.
It is curiosity.
For someone who's from Portugal. All Scandinavian countries make it.
Yes, and the world is ruled by Scandinavia.
No, all countries that have mud or snow, you know, real fall and real winter, all those countries make it. It's not like Poland has some weird stuff.
Go, Captain Diapers. Ciao, Ben. Now I have freedom and I can talk for the rest the way I want without any kind of Maria trying to make pressure on me. Let's go to the office. This next one. It's something. It's not our biggest problem in our marriage, but sure has a lot of influence. And it is Polish people, how to say? Polish people love potatoes. And they can eat potatoes on every size, shape, and any way of cooking them. They just love potatoes. They can, like, and this is our problem. Why it's our problem? Because I love rice. You know, in Portugal we eat a lot of rice, and in Poland they eat a lot of potatoes. So if Maria could, she would eat potatoes every single day for the rest of her life. And you ask, how much do they love potatoes? Enough to sell teddy bears in the shape of potatoes in the supermarkets here. Yes, they have teddy bears that are potato bears. Potato teddy bears. Yes. That's frustrating. Look at this. They even have toys like potato teddy bears. It looks like a poop, but it's a potato. This last one that I'm going to talk on this video. Maybe in the future I can update and make another video with other things, but this last one, it's by far the worst thing that I have found in Poland. And it's something called lektor. What is lektor? Lektor is like the cheap version of dubbing. So they just put a guy that talks over the movie. So you have a movie, the guys are talking, and he talks over the movie. This guy talks over the movie, any expression or something. He just says, like, if it's a sex scene, if it's an action scene, if it's a chasing cars, is just like, oh, here they go, chasing each other. Oh, let me try to show you.
Nie możesz mnie złapać? rozetnę cię na połowę. Tato, na pomoc. To jest...
You see how exciting he is when he talks? She's screaming, Daddy, help me. It's like, Daddy, help me. If you can. When you finish your job, maybe you can come and help me. So this is one of the worst things ever. I'll try to find more and make a second video out of this in the future. So until then, bye. What's the weirdest thing about Poland?
People? Weirdest for me, I don't know.
Maria, what? Do you ever wonder if in few years Guy is going to watch the videos that you make now and she's going to be like...
Ashamed?
She's going to be like, wow, my parents made a video. I remember that day. They left Minsk when they didn't took me for a golf. Those bastards. Have you ever wondered? She'd be like, I remember that day. Autumn of 2020. I remember because I spent the whole year at home. And the only time you went out, you didn't take me for a golf with you. Make shaky videos. So maybe let's try to use the two hands on the holding camera. So, but today I would like to share with you few points of, let me search, wait a second, stop.